Good morning, lovely people. This morning, we're in the lovely little town of Maggie Valley, headed to Cherokee today to do a nice little hike I just found. On the way, I'm going to stop and check out a waterfall. Please come with me. This is a trail down. It's just a very short path from the parking lot. The steps coming back are pretty treacherous, but it's just really steep and a little muddy. But it's well worth the walk. And this is between Maggie Valley and Cherokee. There's a path to go down to the waterfall, but we're not going to do that today. Well, let's go across the bridge. And up to the gristmill. We cannot go inside today. It's been winter time. The inside's locked, but in the summer you're allowed to go in. Okay, this is Deep Plow Gap. It's where the Mingust gristmill is, and it's rated as difficult. We're gonna do part of it, and then I'm gonna go to Collins Creek. It's about 5 miles from this one that's at the Mingust Mill. So today is February the 4th. It's not been real cold here in the mountains. We've had a couple of days of little snow, but it didn't last long. Very unusual for this time of the year in the mountains in North Carolina. It has been a pretty nice winter. Today it's supposed to be like 71. Stop and show you the woods today. Winter mountain woods. Sandy, this is for you, honey. I'm going to dedicate this video to one of my very good friends I went to school with, who doesn't live here in the mountains anymore, but I think she misses it. So this is for you, Sandy. Love you. So I'm still on the Deep Plow Trail. Didn't know there's picnic tables here. There's also a port-a-john. Looks like there's a little arena for riding horses. There's barrels. I'd say that's a staging area for something entertainment they have here. Just going up the trail. I'm gonna get in there. Look how high this water is. We have had so much rain this last month.
Wow.
It's high, but this looks good. Thank you everyone so much for subscribing to my channel and liking. Every week I get a new subscriber, even if it's just one. Eventually that's going to build into 100. It means so much to me because I work so hard to try to bring fun, a little information, a little of my mountain craziness to you guys. And it's a pretty trail. I know there's always people wanting to know about the trails local to the mountains. So join in, share, like, subscribe, comment. Just know I love y'all and I appreciate you so much. Head on up the trail. Seems to be starting to get a little bit steep now. I think we can handle a little bit more steepness though. The trail's rated as difficult, but so far we've only had a couple of slight elevations. It's not been difficult at all. And it's right on the creek. If you guys wonder why I come to Cherokee a whole lot to do trails, one thing, it's beautiful here. For another, it's really close to my home in Maggie Valley. And a third, it's the elk are usually here, and I love to take pictures of the elk. And another thing, this was my childhood playground. We were local to the area, so my parents had a camper, and the three kids, we would come over here and stay at the KOA and go to Dairy Queen and the Ghost Town and Frontierland and go fishing, and we just had a blast. So it brings me a lot of memories back of those times. Makes me kind of sentimental these days because my dad is in the last stages of Alzheimer's. He didn't remember any of this stuff, but I can remember for him. Something I should mention if you come up on this trail is only about a half a mile from where I filmed the elk, so just be aware of your surroundings if you come up here. And also, it's still warm weather, though. I don't think the bear have hibernated at all this year, but the elk are definitely in here because there's water right here. They won't bother you unless you get too close to them, but it is a federal offense to get more than, I think, maybe 500 feet from them, so you can be fined severely if you get too close to them. Take pictures and delay them, just don't touch them. So, do I want to walk across the water, or I want to take a little footbridge? It's a little bit cute little footbridge that we're thinking about as hikers, not getting our feet wet. Guys, another footbridge across the creek. Pretty nice. Okay, I did fall down on that. I'm not hurt, but that's not because it's icy, but because of the mildew. It's really slick. There was a slight elevation, but it's not difficult. Coming up on another ridge. A lot of bridges. These are fun. Growing up, I had family members who had these to get to their house. Hey, my advice for this trail, being as close as it is to the visitor center, I would do this in the late fall or early spring. It is February, early February, and there's been a lot of people up here. Of course, it's a warmer day than an ordinary February day, but it has been packed. So I imagine in the summertime, this is like Interstate 40. Now that's fresh water. You could drink that water without building it. This is the top end of where the glistener starts. Isn't this what life's about? Just get out and enjoy nature.
Thank you for joining me today on part one of this Cherokee adventure. Please join me next week. We'll go to Collins Creek. God bless. See you on the trail, and love y'all.